From the radiant Louis Vuitton stores he designed in Singapore and Hong Kong, to the luxurious Chanel boutiques in Paris and Beverly Hills, to the Christian Dior stores in Shanghai and New York, Peter Marino is an internationally acclaimed architect helping to redefine the modern luxury world. The stores are more like galleries than boutiques and have received innumerable awards for excellence in design and architecture. An Interior Design Hall of Fame member, Peter Marino's signature motifs are sometimes flashy and sometimes subtle, but they always make a luxurious statement. Early on, Marino apprenticed with such masters such as I.M. Pei and George Nelson. He even designed the New York apartments of a number of celebrities and creatives, including Andy Warhol and Yves Saint Laurent. Peter Marino's designs have been featured in New York Magazine, Interior Design, House & Garden, Vogue, W Magazine, and Elle Decor to introduce surprising new shapes, heights, and materials. A true creative and visionary, I'm here with superstar architect Peter Marino to talk about creative collaborations. Peter, you've designed some amazing spaces around the world. Where do you get your creative inspiration?
Generally from everywhere. I mean, I can get it from an opera, I get it from nature, I get it from reading. I read like a voracious amount. The reason I like reading, let's say I'm not a filmy, is because when you read, you picture things and you develop your imagination. So those are my primary sources.
I come to architecture from a different background than most architects. I mean, I sidled into it. I was a sculpture major, and so I come from a fine arts background, not an engineering background. And that, I think, shows in my work. I don't know, I think it does. And it means I'm really interested in the overall shape of the building, and I'm really interested in what I make it out of. That's all. And we're super interested in new materials and high-tech materials. That's the great fun of working for the luxury brands. So I like so much that there are different needs and different demands. It makes it more stimulating for me. So materiality, time and space, is what I consider anything that is a more rewarding experience in life.
So my question is, how do you stay creative when you're still running the business side of things?
I have very good business managers. I'm not... that was really not...
Flavor.
That was so nice
you
of you. Yeah, that was nice of you, but you should meet my CFO.
My company is about 170 people. We're 110 architects. We're 40 interior designers, and then we've got administration. We couldn't do all these stores, but we do the lead stores. We'll take from Vuitton 3 to 5 stores a year. Each of them has to be different, and what each one does is push the brand into newness. Each store is 10% newer than the last. So by the end of a cycle of about 2 to 3 years, you have something that is completely new for the brand.
So Peter, what advice would you give to people launching creative startups today?
Gotta learn to listen. I find a lot of young kids, even who work for me, they're very aggressive, they have their own ideas, which is a prerequisite for being a great designer. But also a prerequisite is learn to be a good listener.
That's smart. Very smart.
You know, they're paying you.
Right.
And you want to listen to the primary requirements. And I find that a lot of young people lose sight of that.
That's interesting. So we're here tonight celebrating this amazing signature.
The pastel colors from Miami.
I'm very excited about that. But how do you pick the right collaborators? And what traits do you look for?
I look for old-fashioned craftsmanship, number one. And then, obviously, you got to get along with the people. There's a personality element.
You've worked in so many amazing cities around the world. Do the cities themselves inspire your work?
I don't... Well, I started saying here, Beirut and Istanbul did, because they're cities with really ancient time things,
right.
So they do. And I have to say, Rome does. A little bit less London. And China doesn't want to look at the past at all.
Right.
We were doing a hotel in China. We showed red lacquer columns in the entrance hall. They said, that reminds us of the Imperial Palace. Get it out. They don't want those associations. They just want new. It's really interesting.
Miami's had a huge boom in the last year and a half. I don't know if you guys follow. I mean, 3 years ago, they couldn't give away condominiums. And now, every single week, we get a phone call, will you do 10,000 feet, will you? I mean, the prices have quintupled, and they've caught up to 2005 towers are going up all over. There's that Faena development, 5 towers, where they've got a lot of the star architects. I mean, they have Norman Foster, they have Rem Koolhaas, they have so Herzog, all working there suddenly in Miami. And it coincides with Craig Roberts' development of what they call the Design District, which used to be a really rundown, dumpy place and is now becoming like our meatpacking district here in New York. Super chic, everybody wants to be there, great restaurants, all the stores, all the design stores. So Miami's had a big renaissance.
Thank you so much.
Thanks.
I'm a big admirer of your
Thanks.
Work.
Will I see you at Art Basel?